KPFA community. Mikko Tolliver here, your social media representative. It's April, and time to find out everything happening this month at KPFA. First off, someone's having a birthday. That's right, KPFA celebrates its 73rd anniversary on April 15th. KPFA was founded by Lewis Hill in 1949, and since then, KPFA has continued its mission of promoting cultural diversity and pluralistic community expression. Join us for a special birthday fundraiser to help continue the long-standing history of KPFA Radio. Donate now at www.kpfa.org/donate. Now for the month of April, KPFA has several live events. And here is Development Director Kevin Hunsanger with a rundown of what's going on in April.
Hi, this is Kevin Hunsanger. I'm KPFA's Development Director, and I produce the event series here. I'm thrilled to announce this month's series, which not only highlights the history of women in comedy, subversive literature, and Coast Salish punk poetry, but we need to keep that going, so I can tell you a little bit more about Alice Walker, who's appearing in a rare live in-person event. There's certainly a little something for everyone below, so we hope to see you soon. Tickets for these events can be purchased online at Eventbrite or via the KPFA website. Please join us on Tuesday, April 5th at 7 p.m. when KPFA welcomes Shawn, Levy, and Debi Durst for this special Zoom event focusing on In on the Joke, the original queens of stand-up comedy. In on the Joke is a hilarious and moving account of the trailblazing women of stand-up comedy who broke down walls so they could stand before the mic. This is perfect for fans of The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel and Hacks. It's going to be on Tuesday, April 5th at 7 p.m. Tickets can be purchased online at Eventbrite or via the KPFA website. Azar, Nafisi will be joining us on Thursday, April 14th at 6 p.m. She's the New York Times bestselling author of Reading Lolita in Tehran, and she'll return with a guide to the power of literature in turbulent times, arming readers with a resistance reading list, ranging from James Baldwin to Zora Neale Hurston to Margaret Atwood. Please visit eventbrite.com or kpfa.org and purchase your tickets for that event now. Join KPFA for a very special in-person event when Beverly Guy-Sheftall hosts Alice Walker and her book Gathering Blossoms Under Fire. From National Book Award and Pulitzer Prize-winning author Alice Walker and edited by critic and writer Valerie Boyd comes an unprecedented compilation of Walker's 50 years of journals, drawing an intimate portrait of her development over five decades as an artist, human rights, and women's activist and intellectual. This very special in-person event will be held on Monday, April 18th at 7 p.m. at the First Congregational Church of Berkeley. Proof of COVID-19 vaccination will be required for entry, and masks are strongly encouraged. Tickets are available at eventbrite.com, at kpfa.org, or at the door. And please join KPFA on Thursday, April 21st at 7 p.m. when Christina Aanestad hosts Sasha, LaPointe and her book Red Paint, the ancestral autobiography of a Coast Salish punk. An indigenous artist blends the aesthetics of punk rock with the traditional spiritual practices of women in her lineage in this bold, contemporary journal to reclaim her heritage and unleash her power and voice while searching for a permanent home. This event will be held Thursday, April 21st at 7 p.m. on Zoom, and tickets are available at eventbrite.com or at kpfa.org. Thank you. Please remember that all proceeds from these events will go towards KPFA. Please also consider supporting us by making a donation today so that our event speaker series can be here for you tomorrow. We thank you.
As we continue to honor the history of KPFA, we want to say happy anniversary to Kris Welch, host of Talkies, which airs on Tuesday to Thursday, 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. And Kris has been at KPFA for 50 years. I sat down with Kris to interview her about her time here. And here is our latest segment of Storytelling for Social Change.
I'm Kris Welch, and I'm the host of the Talkies, which is on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays, weekly at 11, from 11 to noon. And I don't know exactly how long it's been on. It sort of morphed from Living Room, which was on at noon. And that, I don't know when that changed either, except that I do know that I was on the morning show for 25 years. So that that is the, that's the one date I remember. I think probably living room 10 years, and it's just been so much fun. I haven't been able to keep track. So the talkies is, I was told originally that they wanted it to be local news, and I tried, and there is local news, but I've included everything because that's sort of what I do. International news and politics and art and culture, because that's my background. And it's just fun talking to people. That's what it's about. And listener callers. That's, I love that part too.
Congratulations to Jack Foley, host of Cover to Cover, who received a silver medallion from the online print magazine LITTERATEUR RW. The medallion was presented to Foley by the Indian American film actor, writer, activist, and producer Thampi Anthony Thakek. And now it's time for program updates for April with our weekend music department coordinator, Dee Minor.
Hello, I'm Dee Minor, KPFA's weekend music program coordinator and assistant to the director of operations. I also host Let's Talk Music Sundays at 8 p.m. I'm happy to announce the following program updates for April. On April 2nd, Ritmo host Pedro Arroyo will officially host and produce the 7 and 9 p.m. Saturday slot on a weekly basis. Pedro will bring you a show with a slightly different music focus and a new name, Casa Babylon. Casa Babylon will be an eclectic music program which will explore the intersections of contemporary music from Latin America and Iberian Peninsula. Check it out Saturdays, 7 to 9 p.m. Officially starting April 2nd, The Soul Suite with Thomas Shea will be heard from Saturdays, 11 p.m. to Sundays, 1 a.m. Thomas J takes you on a soldier through the land of soul, serving you soul in all sorts of sizes, from modern soul, soul hip-hop, classic soul, neo-soul, soul jazz, and R&B, funk, spoken word, and so much more. I Had That Tape has now moved from its Wednesday slot to Sundays from 9 to 10 p.m. To learn more about the show and DJ Mike Biggs, check the show out on kpfa.org in the program section on the website. After a long break due to the pandemic, starting on April 6th, Chocolate Beats Radio will be back on the air. Listen to the unique blend of world music, soul gospel, conscious hip-hop, electronica funk, jazz, and rare grooves on Wednesdays from 12 a.m. to 1 a.m. in the mornings with Idris Hassan.
Hi, I'm Luis Medina, and I want to invite you to listen to Con Sabor on Saturday evenings from 9 to 11 p.m. on KPFA. Con Sabor features the best in salsa, Latin jazz, Afro-Cuban music from son to timba and more. Con Sabor brings you artist interviews, music news, special segments, and the community music calendar. Now celebrating our 25th anniversary on KPFA, Con Sabor is heard every Saturday night except the last Saturday of the month when Radio Cuba Canta with Emiliano Echeverria is featured. During our 25th anniversary year, Con Sabor will feature special programming and always the best in Afro-Latin music. Saturday nights, 9 to 11, with yours truly, Luis Medina, on listener-sponsored radio, KPFA 94.1 FM, and streaming on kpfa.org.
Hi, y'all. This is Emiliano Lemos. I'm one of the hosts of the Herbal Highway, and I'm here in my backyard with some chamomile and a poodle. The Herbal Highway was created by Karen Sanders in 1997, which means we're celebrating our 25th anniversary this year. Please join us on the third Tuesday monthly to hear tape-recorded vintage Herbal Highway episodes from the early days of the show. And you can find out more information about our anniversary celebrations on Instagram, that's at Herbal Highway, and on Facebook too. Catch you on Tuesdays at 1 p.m.
April 20th, or 420, major rallies will occur across the country in celebration of marijuana, a drug that remains illegal in the U.S., except in 17 states, including California. KPFA will present a special 420 live stream featuring DJ Mike Biggs and segments from a special KPFA broadcast from 1954. We're calling it 420 on 420. Tune in to our social media platforms, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram to see our live DJ performance. And now for a special interview with author Alia Voltz on her book, Home Baked, about her family's history running Sticky Fingers Brownies, an underground marijuana bakery. All right, I'm here with Alia Voltz, and she's gonna talk to us about her book, Home Baked. Alia, hello, welcome to On the Deck.
Thank you so much, mikO.
Yeah, yeah, tell me about this dope book that is about dope.
The jokes write themselves. Yeah. Well, so my folks had the first high volume cannabis edibles business in San Francisco back in the 1970s, the days of Harvey Milk, the days of the People's Temple. It's a really volatile period. They were distributing brownies throughout all of San Francisco's major subcultures.
Like for free?
No, No, it was a business. It was an innovator of cannabis, really one of the first of its kind and the first to distribute high volume. They were doing upward of 10,000 brownies a month back in the day. And of course it was deeply illegal at that time. So it was all very risky. And they were really innovators. My mom especially was really an innovator in the business. Then when the AIDS crisis hit at the beginning of the 1980s and people started to turn to cannabis for relief from some of the devastating effects of HIV/AIDS, Sticky Fingers Brownies, my family's business, transitioned into the very dawn of the medical cannabis movement. So Home Baked follows the evolution from party drug to palliative medicine and opens the path for where we are today with cannabis. And it also follows the transition that a lot of dealers like my mom made from dealer to healer.
Dealer to healer. I love that. You're right, because she was handing it out to people who were in need for pain. It was like really starting the whole medical cannabis before even that was just legal.
It really was. And for the first, the AIDS crisis hit in like 1981 was really the beginning of people falling ill and dying. And there wasn't the first effective pharmaceutical response didn't come along until 1995, 1996 with the advent of protease inhibitors. So for the first 15 years, there really wasn't a medical response that worked. And people turned to cannabis for appetite stimulation, for help with insomnia, for pain relief, and it helped. It brought some relief. So that AIDS activism for a long time was very deeply wedded with cannabis activism. And that's one of the things that I try to chronicle in Home Baked. It's also a celebration of a really vibrant and politically dynamic time in Bay Area history.
So this is really just kind of your childhood growing up. Now, I'm gonna ask, was your mom baking like the actual, like in your kitchen, like as a kid, like you're coming home after school and you're like, oh.
Sure.
Yeah.
Oh, there were periods. Well, the irony here is that my mom can't cook and she's a horrible, horrible cook. She's almost phobic in the kitchen. And so things explode. Everything goes terribly wrong every time she cooks. So she tried to avoid baking.
Yeah.
but there were times that she certainly did. And by the time I was maybe 10 years old, I was really in the depths of the AIDS crisis. Wow. I was baking alongside her and we would also do deliveries together. But much more than a memoir, it's really an exploration of this period in San Francisco history and the Bay Area's vital role as an incubator for not only cannabis reform, but for the social justice movements that surrounded that.
Wow, okay. And so that was definitely things the way they were then versus how they are now. It was illegal then, but now it's legal. How is that working out?
It has changed quite a bit. Not only is it legal today, but the city of San Francisco is organizing a 9-day festival to celebrate
9 days.
Yeah, to celebrate San Francisco's role as a leader in cannabis reform. So I was contacted by city organizations to do these events, which I just thought was absolutely surreal and wonderful. But the group is called Evergreen San Francisco, and the festival runs from April 16th through the 24th. There's something for everybody that you can find out about on evergreensanfrancisco.org, the whole events list. And you can join me on April 23rd. This is a reading, a book signing. There's a Q&A with KPFA's own Sherry Gendelman.
Oh, nice.
Giveaways, we have roller dance performers and drag performances. The doggy diner heads are coming out. It's a whole thing. And it takes place at Fisherman's Wharf Plaza, which was where my mom began the business.
Oh, okay.
Back in 1976.
So it's taking it back to like its origins completely.
Exactly. And my dad's going to be out to answer questions. So it's a whole to do.
Well, your dad's
going to
be there. Great. All right. It's the whole family business. You guys just kind of keep it going.
Exactly.
Okay, great.
Exactly.
And then will your book also be there?
Absolutely.
Available for purchase?
The Green Apple Books will be there with Home Baked. I'll be signing books. We're giving away Home Baked t-shirts that are Sticky Fingers t-shirts reissued from 1977, my dad's design, and all kinds of fun stuff. So, and again, you can check out the whole list of events. There's some really interesting historical things as well as dispensary tours and explorations of what's really available today. And so this is good for people who are cannabis enthusiasts, but also for people who are
if you want
curious.
To learn, right?
Yeah, if you want to find something for insomnia that maybe won't get you high but has some positive effects or things like that, because of course cannabis today has evolved so much and there's really something tailored for every need.
There really is, yeah.
Right? So this festival aims to educate and celebrate our past and future.
I think that's super great. All right, so I think, where else can I get this book? I can get it at bookstores too, right?
Absolutely anywhere. I'm a big indie bookstore fan, so your local independent bookstore is going to be the best place. You can also find it anywhere online,
okay.
Wherever you buy books.
And you probably go to your website. What's your website that we can go
Absolutely, aliavolts.com.
Okay.
Pretty easy to find.
All right, Home Baked by Alia Volts. All right, that's super, super great. I hope you have noticed and enjoyed the changes to KPFA sound after we've upgraded from our analog studio equipment to digital ones. In order to provide you the best quality sound, we will be occasionally shutting down the transmitter for routine equipment maintenance. On a few Sunday mornings from 1 to 4 a.m., you may tune in and hear. Please check our website for more details. KPFA is on social media. Find us on your favorite platforms for news headlines, live stream events, show info, and more. We are having a Follow Us on Social Media campaign for the first 2 weeks of April, and we want you to tell your friends to join the KPFA community. Our goal is to get as many people to follow, share, like, and promote us to their friends and family. Remember, we're community powered. We need 5,000 new followers across all of our platforms, so follow us online. That's at KPFA 94.1 on Facebook and at KPFA Radio on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and TikTok. And you can also visit us at www.kpfa.org for more information on the station and events or to stream your favorite KPFA shows. All right, that's it for this month's announcements. Tune in next week, and also you can always get more information at www.kpfa.org.
Listening to 94.1 KPFA and 89.3 KPFB in Berkeley, 88.1 KFCF in Fresno, 97.5 K248BR in Santa Cruz, 94.3 K232FC in Monterey, and online worldwide at kpfa.org.